Want to run Ollama with OpenCode and you just don't know how to get started? Well, this video is for you. In the next few minutes, we're going to just jump in and get Ollama working with OpenCode. All right, let's jump straight to the video. All right, just to jump more into the details, we're going to go look at the OpenCode documentation. We're going to start with providers here. As you can see, we've gone to the provider section in the documentation, and this is just a brief description of how to add different custom models. In our case, we're going to be only looking at Ollama. But essentially, it's very similar. You always have the provider name, and the options for the provider. So we're going to scroll down to where we see Open Ollama, and we'll see Ollama over here. All right, so we can see here's Ollama, and the instructions are very clear. We need to add this to our opencode.json, and once all this is set up, then we can run it. Most important things I would say here is the port IP here. You can see it's 11434. This is the port that Ollama works from, and the model here also is quite important. This is according to Ollama's specifications, what the model should be called, and then the name of the model. So what will be displayed is Ollama Local, and then it'll be Ollama 2. But these are more critical. All right, so let's just jump into it and get it set up. First things first, you might not have a config file set in your global, and you might have to set this up yourself. So what you want to do is you actually want to create your config opencode.json config essentially. For more details where you can find that is if you go to the config section of the documentation, so over here, they'll tell you where it looks, and they'll also tell you where it is located. So if you're wondering how we're doing this, that's where it's from. All right, so we're just gonna start that. We can see there's nothing in my config at the moment. We're gonna install Ollama right here. So just going back to the documentation, press this button to copy it, and then we're gonna jump to our code base, and we're just gonna literally copy it through. I'm gonna paste it. I am gonna change a few things here because I think I want to download a different model. So to show you that this video is new, I'm just gonna jump to Ollama quick. So if you've never installed Ollama before, you always want to go to the Ollama models webpage. You can click on models here, and then on models you can click, and we can determine which model we want to work with. I'm going to choose the Quen 3. This was, you know, the latest hype one, but I'm going to use a smaller model here. So they've got a few different ones that they've recently updated, and you can always go to view more, and you'll see here they've got the different months that it was last update. So we're going to just select Quen 3 8B. This is the smaller model that we can just run at 8 billion parameter. So essentially what we really care about is this name, because Ollama is going to use that name. So we jump back to our code. We want to go Ollama run, and then we want to paste that model name. So I haven't updated Ollama in a while. So let's just quickly update my Ollama. All right, so now we're pulling in the new model after update. So just remember how to run it is Ollama run with the model name. But the model name is also quite important for us if we actually want to update here. So we don't want to use Ollama 2. We actually need to put that model name in here to make sure it works. So it should be Quen 3B, and we're just gonna keep this the same. Own. And anything else, we just got the Ollama, and I think that's fine. So to save in Vim, you can just go WR write, and then once it's saved, you can go colon quit, and now we've got it all set up in our config.json. So let's just make sure the model is up. So it's going to take a bit of time. I'm going to wait for this download to happen, and then I'll be back in a second. All right, so now we're back. So we can see Ollama's download our Quen 3B model. Just to check if it's working, we can just say... all right, so we can see it's got the thinking model, and it's making a plan so it can actually make out the snake game. So let's just see if it actually starts doing the code. You can see it's getting to quite a bit of things, and we can see it's starting to print, so which is great. We don't want it to send everything, so we're just going to quit this. If you guys have never used Ollama before, to see all the models you've downloaded from Ollama, just go Ollama list. And you'll see there's all the different types of models I've downloaded over the years. One thing to note about Ollama and mainly agentic processes, especially tool calling, most models aren't built to tool call. So it's very important that you actually download a model that actually can use tools. So if you wanted to use in your agentic coding systems, definitely pick a model that has good capability or accuracy calling tools. This is something that was always been a problem for me in the past when I was building with AI. I wanted to use Ollama or open source models about 2 years ago, but they just weren't great at tool calling, but they've come a long way since. But just always make sure you understand it's not as accurate as some of the premium models, and that's why sometimes it won't call your tool. And maybe further fine tuning might be needed to make sure it actually calls the tools that you actually request. So just keep that in mind when using Ollama. It might not work the way that you expect from premium models. All right, so that's out the way. We've already saved our config just to double check. Okay, everything is there. Great. Okay, with our config set up, let's just do open code. And let's just do slash models and see what is here. If we can get Ollama. So we can see our Ollama model is here now in the config. It's Qwen 3 8 billion parameter model that I was just showing you earlier. So let's just try that and see if it's working. Let's see if we can see what this code base is about. Tell me. All right, there we go. So we can see it's starting to, I think. One thing to note is we are using Qwen 3, the 8 billion parameter model, which is very, very small compared to the original one. So accuracy is not going to be as great as what you hear in the news reports and things like that, because it's quantized down. But for the main purposes, this could work very nicely as a local code editor. So say maybe at the airport, you don't have access to internet or something like that, or traveling. Now you can use Ollama with open code in your code base as well, traveling anywhere. Anyway, if this video helped you, please drop a comment down below, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, guys.